The Phorid flies swarm the battling bullet ants, searching for the perfect spot to lay eggs on the far larger insects. Within hours, these eggs will hatch, and the maggots will burrow below the exoskeletons of their host. It was once found by the biologist E.O. Wilson that a single tree in the Peruvian Amazon had about the same number of ant species as the entirety of the British Isles. And when one begins to look at other trees and through the leaf litter, the diversity of ant species here becomes dizzying. One ant, however, really dwarfs the rest in both size and infamy. Paraponera clavata, the bullet ant. At about 2.5 centimeters in length, this worker is very large for an ant, and in these forests, only the obscure Dinoponera is larger. Paraponera are most well known for their painful stings that they use to defend themselves, or their colony, from vertebrate attacks, warning any intruder that gets too close with stridulation, an audible noise made by rubbing the plates of the abdomen, and with golden setae on the front legs that look like little yellow socks, both being clear aposematic signals to get potential predators to back off, though these warnings are often ignored by YouTube wildlife presenters. This worker is one of a few hundred sisters living in a colony situated at the base of this tree, who work tirelessly to increase the reproductive output of their mother, the queen. To do this, they forage, often high into the canopy, but also on the forest floor, which is where our worker has chosen to search for arthropod prey. This is a harsh world of voracious predators even the mighty Paraponera must be aware of. There is one threat, though, that the ant takes more seriously than any other, a bullet ant from a neighboring colony. This is a direct threat to the future of the worker's own colony, and so this intrusion cannot be tolerated. Our ant springs into action and goes on the offensive. Within seconds, the two ants are locked in combat, their large mandibles biting down with a vice-like grip. The jaws are so powerful, they easily rip limbs off, leaving open wounds dripping hemolymph, the technical term for insect blood. While the ants do battle, the scent of this fresh hemolymph drifts through the leaf litter. The smell is irresistible to one of the jungle's most gruesome predators. Within mere minutes of the first drops being spilt, they arrive. This is the tiny forward fly, Apocephalus paraponerae. These are parasitoids, animals that lay their eggs on a host, which their offspring devour alive. Up in North America, a different species of Apocephalus lays its eggs on bees and wasps, and due to the manipulation of the host's behavior, have been given the name zombie fly. Here in the Amazon, however, this species targets the giant bullet ant as a host for their maggots, only attacking ants that are severely injured or dying, as normally, Paraponera are too well armored and dangerous, and any zombie fly that dares approach a nest will be met with a horde of angry ants, all trying to crush the tiny insect in their massive mandibles. However, distracted by combat, our worker barely notices the tiny fly, and there are more than one. The Apocephalus are so small, and the Paraponera are so large, multiple flies, each laying multiple eggs, can parasitize this one worker. This in turn has allowed this fly species to reach quite high abundance in the rainforest. And so whenever a bullet ant gets injured, a swarm of zombie flies materialize out of the forest. Our worker finally takes notice and tries their best to get them off, but the mandibles of the Paraponera's dying enemy hold them in place, and the zombie flies continue to arrive and lay eggs on the helpless, trapped ant. Our ant finally breaks free of the jaws of the enemy worker and limps back towards the colony, but the ant is now the walking dead. In only a few hours, the 20 or so Apocephalus eggs will hatch, and the maggots will burrow into the Paraponera's body, and within 48 hours, they will have consumed the ant and crawled out into the soil, leaving behind only a hollow husk. Ants like Paraponera are critically important parts of the ecosystem in the Amazon. Here they are major herbivores, predators, prey, and ecological engineers, shaping the forest itself. It is a savage world, one where nothing is wasted and a single death can bring about new life. But as our global civilization spreads deeper and deeper into these forests, this kingdom of the ants and the many other organisms that inhabit it are under unprecedented threat. Here, it is logging, agriculture, and gold mining that threaten the future of these ecosystems. And so I beg you to do your research and make sure any hardwood, gold, or meat you purchase is not coming from this destruction. Elsewhere in the world, ants also have remarkable stories to tell. In these same rainforests, army ants nomadically roam the forest floor. In the deserts of North America, harvester ants collect seeds to store for later, and even in the concrete jungle of cities, pavement ants have epic battles for supremacy, all of which you can witness here on Ecotasia.